Hello there, fellow model makers, and welcome to the fourth and last part of my Kitty Hawk 1/48 scale AH-1Z Viper build. Last time, we completed the basic paint scheme of the kit. However, there is still plenty more to be done, starting with masking for painting the wings and the horizontal stabilizers. I apply light layers of Mr. Color 335 Medium Sea Gray. Once the grey paint was dry, I masked off even more sections, leaving only areas where black paint was to be sprayed. As you can see, I tried to maintain the marble look even with the black paint. I now seal the paint job with some clear varnish. While the varnish dried, I used this time to cut and clean some of the remaining assemblies, like the rotor blades. Once again, we run into some extra plastic from the ejection pin marks that needs to be cleaned. The rotor assembly can now be put together. The engine exhausts, which I had left out, are now painted black. The tail and main rotor were both given a black base so that they would match the rest of the kit. The engine exhausts are dry brushed with some aluminium paint so that the details inside them are made more visible. Another sub-assembly that needs painting is the gun turret, which is painted with Mr. Color 308 Grey. With a gloss varnish nicely dry, I started applying the decals. The decals in the kit are super thin, so they really go down well. However, they are also very easy to accidentally fold or tear, so do be careful with them. Here's another place where the instructions let you down. There is no painting guide for the main rotors. Well, I used whatever tidbits of information there were in the instructions, and for the rest, I relied on the internet and my imagination. I had covered the decals with another layer of gloss varnish earlier. Now that the varnish is dry, I can apply Tamiya's black panel line accent color. The extra panel line wash was removed with a Q-tip moistened with odorless spirit. I now use Tamiya's X19 Smoke for the post shading. While looking at reference pictures on the net, I found that sometimes these helicopters could get really grimy and dirty, especially when they were in an operational area or were being used in military exercise. The fact that they are light grey in color does not help with hiding the dirt. I will be trying to duplicate this heavily grimed look. Every now and then, I get carried away with the post shading, as I did here on the tail stabilizers. Anyway, it's not a difficult fix. I just take the original color and spray over the post shading till it's light enough. Similarly, I can subdue excessive post shading in other parts of the kit as well. Now I give the kit a couple of coats of matte varnish. With the matte varnish dry, I remove the canopy masking. There was some mist on the inside of the canopy, but it was easily removed by wiping with a moist Q-tip. There were some hard to get areas, but eventually I was able to clean up the canopies. I still wonder what this substance was. Time to put together the weapons load, and I start off by cutting and cleaning the pieces. As per usual, I drill tiny exhausts on the missiles. The parts are given a black pre-shading and then painted in their respective colors. It was time now to glue in all the remaining bits and bobs, like the engine covers and the open canopy frames. Right then, fellow model makers, here it is, my take on Kitty Hawk's 1/48 scale AH-1Z Viper. I hope you enjoyed the video series. In case you did, please do leave a like and subscribe. Also, do press the bell icon to activate notifications. Till next time, good luck and happy model making!